What's up, guys? This is Kephis. Welcome to Class Course, where we take a brief look at a specific class and spec from World of Warcraft and break down their core rotation. So if you're not too familiar with how to play a particular class, you've come to the right place. But if you're looking for something a little bit more advanced, like stat weights or talent builds, you might want to check out the class discords, and I will provide links to them in the description below. Today we're going to be talking about Retribution Paladins. Ret Paladins are by far my favorite class to play in the game, and Kephis here has been my main since Wrath of the Lich King. When I play a Ret Paladin, I feel nearly unstoppable. Seriously, just look at how many adds I'm able to take on here in Nashatar.
Patty cake, baker's man! Make me a cake as fast as you can!
This is because Ret Paladins provide a mix of strong DPS and great survivability, which makes them viable in pretty much every situation they might find themselves in. Ret Paladins have a lot of useful abilities in their spellbook, but to keep things simple, we're just going to focus on the core rotation. The rotation is all about building and spending holy power. You can build up to 5 holy power at a time, and the trick is to not overcap your holy power. Blade of Justice generates 2 holy power, and Judgment generates 1 holy power, but it will also cause your target to take 25% increased damage from your next ability that consumes holy power. And lastly, you have Crusader Strike, which generates 1 holy power, but it has 2 charges. These are your core abilities which will generate holy power, but you also have a few abilities in your talents that will generate holy power if you choose them. Hammer of Wrath and Consecration will both generate holy power, and Wake of Ashes generates 5 holy power, so you want to be a lot more mindful when using this ability. Try to use it first when you haven't generated any holy power. And from top to bottom, this is the priority in which you will want to use these abilities in order to generate holy power, unless doing so would cause you to overcap your holy power. To keep yourself from doing this, you will need to start spending your holy power, and your main ability for doing that is Templar's Verdict, which will consume 3 holy power. But if you're fighting multiple targets, you can switch to Divine Storm, which will also consume holy power. These are your 2 core abilities that you will use to consume holy power, but there are 2 key abilities that you will find in your talents that will consume holy power if you choose them. Execution Sentence also consumes 3 holy power, but it has a cooldown, so you'll want to prioritize this over Divine Storm or Templar's Verdict. You also have Inquisition, which will consume up to 3 holy power to increase your damage for a limited time. The buff will last 15 seconds for each holy power you spend, up to 45 seconds. So your first priority when spending holy power is to apply Inquisition, and while the buff is active, you can focus on your other spenders. When the buff is about to fall off, you'll want to reapply it. But no matter which talents you choose to go with, the fundamental priority system involves building holy power and spending it before you overcap. And don't forget that you can use Avenging Wrath on cooldown to temporarily increase your DPS. Hopefully this video has helped get you started, but keep in mind that in Battle for Azeroth, there are a lot of factors that can change up how your class is played. Talents, Azerite armor, essences, and even PvP talents can have a significant impact on your rotation. So if you would like more information on all of that, again, I highly recommend that you check out the class discords. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, let me know by clicking that like button. And feel free to share it with your friends so they can enjoy it as well. Don't forget, you can subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to be notified as soon as new videos are posted. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and if you'd like, you can support this channel on Patreon. Links to all of this can be found in the description below. This is Kephis. Until next time.